GPU rendering. Is it as great as people say? Let's test it today and answer this question. For this, I will be using Chaos V-Ray GPU. Rendering is a complex task, and it is one of the biggest challenges to computers to calculate this. In general, the machine can handle this process in two ways. A computer can process renders via CPU or GPU. V-Ray GPU also gives the possibility to use a hybrid rendering mode that utilizes both CPU and the GPU devices, taking benefits from all available hardware on a specific workstation. As GPU hardware is developing quickly, it increases performance at a lower cost. This is the main reason why it makes GPU rendering so popular. So let me present my results on two machines using different rendering methods. Firstly, I will show the main specifics on both machines so we have a clear understanding of what is going on. The first machine is my PC with Intel Core i9-7960X and NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1070. I have 2x32GB RAM on the computer, so in total 64GB. The second machine is a laptop MSI Creator 15. Here, big thanks for NVIDIA Studio for being a partner of this video and sending me this laptop. The laptop has Intel Core i7-10875H and NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3070. With a 2x increase in rendering performance as well as a 2x increase in graphics memory compared to the Series 20, working with very large 3D models is faster than ever before. Besides, it has 32GB RAM with the possibility to increase up to 64GB. What I really like about it is that you can use fingerprint or face recognition to unlock the laptop. Another cool option is a touchscreen that makes the user experience much better. Plus, I really like the big touchpad that makes working without a mouse way more comfortable. With that being said, let me show you the render options we have. So with V-Ray, we can use both CPU and the GPU rendering. After installation, we only need to change the renderer. Anyway, if you want to render with CPU, you need to choose V-Ray, in my case version 6, hotfix free. While if you want to use GPU rendering, we'll choose V-Ray GPU, for me also version 6. Now for GPU rendering, V-Ray offers a couple of options. We can render with CUDA engine or RTX. Plus, we can select a GPU device for denoising as well. Let's start with the default engine, CUDA. It offers hybrid rendering that uses both CPU and GPU devices. You can choose only GPU. In the case of my machine, it is NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3070. Or only the CPU. We can also choose RTX as an engine. And here, we can use only a GPU device for rendering. It is worth mentioning that if you have more than one GPU available, it will be listed here as well. Similarly for the CUDA engine. Plus, as mentioned before, we can additionally choose GPU for denoising if we wish. Now, I will show you my results on both machines. Here are my input parameters. I used the living room scene from our visualization training for testing. Link to the course in the corner. I rendered the images with a size of 4000 by 2000 pixels. Also, I set the noise threshold equal to 0.005. For the CPU rendering, I rendered with Bucket as well as Progressive Image Sampler. I chose the Brute Force as the primary engine to be able to use the light mix. For the GPU rendering, I chose the default settings and I rendered with Bucket and Progressive Image Sampler as well to test all the options. Here you can see my render time results. First of all, when we look at all the options, Bucket Image Sampler is a winner. However, this is not a super large difference. In my case, most of the time, it is just a couple of minutes saved. But here remember, sometimes a few minutes make a difference, for example, if you render animation. Anyway, I will leave only the times with the Bucket Image Sampler to make the comparison more obvious. So you can see that when I use the CPU rendering method, the results are better on my computer, which makes sense as I have a stronger CPU there. But still, less than 2 hours for an image of this quality is a really good result. Okay, but let's go further. When I use the CUDA engine, utilizing only a graphic card, I get almost 2x better results on the laptop. It makes perfect sense as my graphic card on PC is not as good for today's standards. But when I use a hybrid rendering, the laptop is still a winner, but the difference is pretty small, less than a minute. It is because my PC makes up for speed with a good processor. With the last option, with the CUDA engine, using only the CPU, the PC wins this battle unquestionably. PC was more than 2 times faster than the laptop. The reason for this is obviously the stronger processor in my computer. And finally, the results from another engine from GPU rendering, RTX. Here, a clear winner is a laptop. It rendered the image only for less than 90 minutes. This is a great result, isn't it? Here you can see that NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3070 makes a real jump. To sum up, on my PC, the fastest method of GPU rendering is almost 2 times faster than CPU rendering, while on the laptop this difference is more than 5 times. Comparing only the rendering time, it is obvious to choose GPU rendering on both machines. However, it makes much more sense on the laptop. Now, render times are definitely not the only thing to consider. To make an honest comparison, we need to compare the outputs as well. So I saved everything in the history panel. First of all, you can see that there is no difference in the output when rendering by different engines using the V-Ray GPU. It doesn't matter if I choose CUDA or RTX, the image looks the same. However, it is not the case if we compare the image rendered by CPU rendering and GPU rendering methods. On the left-hand side, I have the visualization from the CPU rendering and on the right-hand side, from GPU. You can notice that reflections look slightly different. Materials look different. We can see quite a big difference in the fabrics. You can see it especially on the sofa. As I read on the Chaos website, because V-Ray GPU is a very different engine, the bump map itself can look a bit different compared to V-Ray. And it seems like a case here. Also, the light works differently. The light spreads differently in the room. I think the biggest difference is in the environmental lighting. Let me show you the light pass for this. Here we can see a clear difference. It looks like the contrast between light and shadow is more prominent in CPU rendering, which makes the detail more visible. I will show you also the reflection path, so you can see the difference more clearly. You can notice these similarities in small elements, like the decor on the table as mentioned previously, or in the standing lamp, but also on the wall materials, for example. Now, a couple of important notes. The image was originally created in V-Ray, and to make fair comparison, I would need to create visualization from scratch in V-Ray GPU and adjust its materials, lighting, etc. in this. On the other hand, it will be hard to compare if we have various parameters. Another thing to be aware of is that not all the features are supported by V-Ray GPU. You can find all information on the Chaos website. So everything that has this green icon works in V-Ray GPU, while the red icon presents non-supported features. Some options have additional nodes that indicate some limitations. The biggest concern for me is the lack of transparency mode in V-Ray material, which makes a huge difference especially in exterior images, where there are a lot of plants. Anyway, most of the features are supported and with each upgrade there are more possibilities, so I'm sure the Chaos didn't say their last word, and there will be tons of improvements in the future. To sum up, GPU rendering has definitely enormous potential. The render times are very good, and I can imagine that with the use of the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4090, which is the best in the market right now, the times will be ridiculously fast. So let's answer the question, when it payoffs to use GPU rendering in V-Ray? So first of all, you need to have a graphic card from NVIDIA. But not whatever graphic card in the market, you need a good one. Grid parameters of this are a must if you want to take a real advantage. Another thing that speaks for the GPU option is the fact that you can utilize multiple GPU devices, which increases significantly its potential to render faster. And of course, taking into consideration the economic aspect, GPU rendering is a choice to go. Also, for the quality I'm looking for in images, GPU rendering will work fine for interiors, but I'm not sure about exteriors because of the lack of the transparency mode. So if you want to make sure GPU rendering is for you, I think testing on your machine will be the best option if possible, as you can see how much time you can save and if it is worth compromising it with the lack of some features that are not supported. As GPU rendering is getting more and more popular and it develops really quickly, for my future computer, I will definitely invest in a very strong GPU, or maybe even two. If you want to watch more videos on this topic, check out my suggestions. Bye!